Football, 2 days in a row. How about that? Of course, last night's game was cut short by that weather delay. Be prepared to take on a state championship team.
Methodically, I suppose.
Well, speaking of tonight's game, what adjustments do you have to make due to the rain?
Really none. You know, we're a pretty good bad weather team.
I wanted to mention last week that the Bulldogs committed 8 penalties throughout the entire game and they ended up losing. Tonight they've committed 1 penalty and they lead 7-0.
And Bai told me that his favorite memory was bringing home the Class 6A state championship trophy last year for the first time in history to the best community in the world.
And they're averaging just 37.5 points per game with an unblemished record of 2-0 in the conference. Now the St. Charles North Stars come into this game averaging just 16.8 points per game, and they suffered their first loss of the season last week against Geneva. So on paper, the Bulldogs win this one, but as you know, the game's not played on paper. The Bulldogs came into this game with 30 sacks on the season. That's 15 times the number of sacks Elgin had coming into tonight's game, and well, they each have one tonight. Eventually, they called the game, so here we are picking it up in the first quarter with 4 minutes, 30 seconds left on the clock. Game's tied at 7.
Finally here, the Batavia-Geneva game. These two schools first met back in 1913, and there are 5 ties between them. Who are you greeting here on the sidelines just before this?
We got alumni, we got parents, I got my brother, I've got the 8th grade football team here at Batavia.
He has a sign hanging in his classroom that says, "Frailty, thy name is Batavia." So naturally, Batavia's looking for revenge tonight. Batavia has 35.0 sacks on the season. How are you going to protect your quarterback?
Jeez. Sorry, are they hurt? Is anybody hurt that you know of?
Zeddy's also added that a 1-win season is worthwhile as long as that win is against Geneva. Just goes to show you that rivalry continues after graduation.
Hey, Caitlin, are you okay down there on the sidelines? Did you make it through tonight?
I did. I'm okay. I wasn't trampled. I'm just shaking with it. And hey, guys, this win begs the question, what frailty? The Bulldogs earn their 4th consecutive victory against Geneva and hand those Vikings their first loss of the season. I'm not shivering yet like I usually am, but check out this field. It's really slippery. These senior Bulldogs are 41-4 in their last 4 years here and 24-0 in the conference. In fact, Batavia's last conference loss was October 15th, 2010 to St. Charles North. But the following week, they went on to beat Streamwood 50-0. Now the playoff pairings will be announced tomorrow night at 7 p.m. There's a party in the cafeteria and our live broadcast starts at 7:45 p.m. Batavia hosts Streamwood here next week. We will see you there. Our broadcast starts at 7. Good night from the sidelines.